Hey guys, welcome back to the channel. Thank you so much for clicking on this video. And I told y'all, we're gonna try to get through this before July. Probably not. I think the last ones are gonna end up being in August. I told y'all don't quote me on that from the last video when we were doing this. But we're gonna continue on with my 100 favorite movies of all time 2024 edition. So of course, as always, this is my list. It's gonna be different from your list, where our lists are not gonna look the same. Just let me know if there happens to be a movie here or there that happens to be on your list. And if it's not, quite all right. I think last time I said I don't have any like superhero movies, maybe not, but I looked and I think I have two superhero movies, but not like the one that you probably think. So coming in at number 40, this is a 2017 movie. This is Logan. Even though there is a great ending to this character, I am still looking forward to Deadpool and Wolverine. 39, this is going to be a 2009 movie, another Quentin Tarantino movie, Inglourious Basterds. I think I still have one more Quentin movie in here. I can't remember. Not the movie that you're probably thinking. 2000, what year is it? 2019. I love 2019. 2019 had so many great movies in my personal opinion, because I have so many fucking movies of 2019. And this is not the last 2019 movie. I think there's still like one more that's a little bit up higher. Hint, hint. But this is 1917. Wow, this just looks amazing. It was amazing. So amazing that I bought the movie, y'all. And that's a lot. Like, you're probably like, what? No. If you know me, you know I don't do, like, physical media. Unless I, like, truly, truly love the movie. And I truly, truly love the movie. Because I bought this. I paid full price. I didn't do my, what's it called? Black Friday sale. Number 37 is a 2004 movie. This is one of my favorite, like, natural disaster movies. Day After Tomorrow. I'm going to stay my ass with Jake Gyllenhaal in that library. Number 36. This is a 2016 movie. I had recently rewatched it. And unfortunately, it hurts my heart. But I didn't enjoy it as much. I don't know. Maybe I just wasn't, like, in the right, like, mindset. I don't know, which hurts me. And that's Keanu. I know it's a ridiculous movie. They do all this for a fucking cat. But y'all see the damn cat? The cat is, oh wait, the poster, the cat is so cute. And I love it. It was up higher, like way up higher. Not way up higher, but it would have still been in like this 20 mix. Number 35, we're going to 2014. And we're going to a little animated movie. And this little animated movie also makes me cry sometimes. This is Big Hero 6. Oh my god, such a great movie. Adore it. And I just went up. Hey guys, editing shorter hair me. Apparently I don't know how to count, y'all. Okay, I'm surprised I hadn't done this previously. Apparently I missed number 34. And that's going to be a 2012 movie based on a true story. You already know I love me my based on a true story movies. And this is going to be Argo. And that's all I'm gonna say about this one. Let's go ahead and get back to the original video. Number 33, and we're going to 2003. And this is yet another, I think this is the last superhero movie I have on my list. I don't know, don't quote me. Stop quoting me, y'all. Don't you pull the receipt. Love the sequel over the first one. This is part two, and this is X2. Okay, absolutely, you know, it's just, I love it. Number 32. We're going to 2018. You know, I love me some board games, but actually I love this movie before I was into board games officially. But this is just such a fun little movie where game night goes horribly wrong. I love me some Jason Bateman. I love me some Rachel McAdams. This is game night, by the way, okay? And it's just so much fun. Like, I would love to be part of a game night. Not to this extent, you know, a game night. I would never find you though, so you would be lost forever. So maybe not. 31. This is a 2010 movie, and I'm probably gonna get a lot of like, you have part 3 but you don't have part 1? What? And I'm just gonna tell you off the bat, I really don't like part 2. It made me cry. I cry a lot in movies, don't I? I love them are in here. But this is an animated movie, and I think it gives such a beautiful closure to this little trilogy. And then it's like, we didn't need a fourth one, but then we got a fourth one, and then that one was also beautiful. This is Toy Story Part 3. Number 30, we're going to 2010. I got a pocket full of sunshine. Easy A. And we're gonna move on to number 29. And I think this is the last 2019 movie, I think. What is this beautiful movie over here? You telling me? You telling me that I missed seeing this in theaters? If I had the opportunity to watch it in theaters, I definitely would watch it again. Well, I would watch it for the first time. But this movie wow, like probably my most surprising of the year. And I saw it like really late in the year, but this movie has definitely blown me away. And Alita Battle Angel loves it. Number 28, 1982 classic. I watched it for the first time, I think for the first year that I did my 13 Nights of Fright. So we of course already established I don't do horror movies, right? Like I don't do like jump scare demonic horror movies. But when it comes to like classic movies, you know, I'm like, oh, it's like not CGI, it's like more here, like I can handle it, right? Because it's not like too real in this time that we are now. I'm not taking anything away from it. I'm watching it. I said, oh my god, this is so good. Yes. No! It was so scary. Okay, at one point I don't remember what part it was, obviously when the thing comes at you. Okay, so this is the thing, John Carpenter's the thing, scared the bejesus out of me. I said, I don't like it. But then like as a, you know, movie continued, because I was there watching it like a champ. And then I was like, oh my god, this movie is like amazing. Number 27, we're gonna go to the 90s, 96. This is my favorite slasher movie, and I know a lot of people really love them. And I actually like all, number 4, probably like my least favorite. I think it's number 4, but Scream. We're doing the first one, the classic, the OG. We're going on to number 26. This is 2013. This one is based on a true story, and it has a Tom Hanks. Okay, wait, is it based on a true story? Yes, I believe it is based on a true story. Y'all already know I love me some Tom Hanks. I love me some based on a true story. I'm about 80% sure this is based on a true story. I don't remember very well. Captain Phillips. Number 25, we're going back to the 80s. 89. This is my favorite Disney princess, okay? I said it before when we talked about the creature from the Lost Lagoon. I got the love for the sea creatures. So the Little Mermaid. I've never really been about Beauty and the Beast, The Lion King. Those have never been like my favorites at all. It's always been the Little Mermaid. Oh, yeah, I know I'm always having problems with my damn car finished up. Okay, so I'm not sure where it finished, but Beauty and the Beast and The Lion King are not even like second or third place, to be honest. After The Little Mermaid, Peter Pan probably comes in second, and then Aladdin would be my follow-up choices, and then like Beauty and the Beast, and like it's honestly one of my least favorites. I didn't cry when Mufasa died. Moving on to number 24. This is a 2001 movie. This has my boyfriend Marlon Wayans. I love him. Okay, the first one I do really love as well, but the second one is just so much better. I can still fuck with part 3, but the rest ones after that, I'm just like, no. Okay, we're gonna act like those don't exist. This is Scary Movie Part 2. You already know I love me some comedy. I love me some Russian comedy. I love me some Marlon Wayans, the Wayans brothers, and like, this is great. So right now I definitely have a strong hand. Hold on to me, please, and subscribe. Number 23 is a 2014 movie. Ooh, that kind of hurt. Hold on. The 2014 movie. This is one that definitely flew under the radar for not just me, but like lots of people. Okay. And then like next thing you know, everybody is all like, hold up. Wait a minute. What is going on here? This is John Wick. Number 22. We got a 2004 movie. This is a movie that obviously had to be on my list somewhere or another if you truly know me, or just because I'm a girl, right? It's like, oh, where the hell is The Notebook at? Because what the hell do we want? What do I want? I don't know. Last one on the list. We got number 21. This is a 2011 movie. It's Harry Potter and the Deathly Hallows Part 2. Yes, where my Slytherin's at. This keeps falling down. Of course, Harry Potter had to be on my list. I do plan on reading the books because I haven't read the books. Can't believe that. I know, right? So this is the next 20 movie installments of my favorite movies of all time, 2024 edition. Let me know if any of my movies are on your list. I'm sure some are probably up higher. Most of these are probably not on their list, and that is quite all right. Number 20 will be another Harry Potter movie. I mean, obviously, I already said that I don't really like part one, so you can already snatch or scratch that one off your list. But what movie do you think, Harry Potter movie, do you think is gonna be number 20 on my list? Another hint, it's one that a lot of people don't really like. I feel like, why do people not like this movie so much? So that could kind of give it away of which one it might be, because it's not gonna be like the normal ones, because you know it's mean. It's never the obvious, but I love it. I'm just like, I don't understand why I don't like this one that much, but I love it, and that's okay because it's my list. Okay, but yeah, if you made it this far, don't forget to like, comment, share, subscribe, and until next time, I'll see you guys at concessions. Bye.